How's it going? My name is Brent Hilton. I'm with Wholesale Solar in Mount Shasta, California. I wanted to take some time today to make a video on the IronRidge ground mount. This is our go-to solution that we send for ground-mounted solar systems to customers nationwide. Being that 98% of those customers are do-it-yourselfers, it was really important for us to find a solution that was not only high quality, but fully engineered for permitting and easy enough for the typical do-it-yourselfer to install without the use of a contractor. I'm going to start by giving you a visual of all the various components of this system, and then I'm going to take you behind the scenes on my ground mount right here and show you exactly where these components are integrated into the structure. This is the IronRidge top cap. This is the device that sits on top of your vertical pipe coming out of the ground. It supports the horizontal pipe running east and west. The U-bolts that I'm holding in my hand right here are going to bolt down on top of the horizontal pipe. These can be fitted for 2-inch or 3-inch galvanized Schedule 40 steel. You're going to notice on the back side of the top cap right here, there's two set screws. You just take these and torque them down to the appropriate values, and that is going to hold the caps in place on the vertical pipe. The next thing I want to show you is the XR1000 rail that I'm holding right here, also the rail connector bracket that mounts to the side extrusion. This is a simple nut and bolt assembly. This can slide up and down the rail wherever you need it to be. Also comes with a 2-inch or 3-inch galvanized U-bolt to attach to the horizontal pipe. Here we have the mid-clamp. You'll see that this is a threaded T-bolt here. We've got a metal plate that goes in between module frames, and we've got a nut on the top. This is the device that goes in between solar panels and secures them to the XR1000 rail. You can see them lined up right here. Each mid-clamp is securing two panels side by side with a small 1/4-inch gap in between the module frames. This is the end clamp. This is the device that secures the outermost edges of your solar panels to the rail, so the bottom of the array and the top of the array. You can see we have a simple bracket here with a nut and bolt that's going to secure the panel to the rail. You can see right now the bottom edge of this array, you've got your end clamp securing the modules to the rails. This is the Weeb DMC. This is the device that grounds the solar panel frame to the rail, so you definitely want to make sure you get these on the mid clamps. You've got a hole right here in the center, that's so you can slide it onto the threaded T-bolt of your mid clamp. You'll notice the sharp circles here in each corner. When you torque down the mid clamp, those are going to bite into the solar panel frame as well as the rail, properly grounding the solar panel to the rail. Here we are looking at the underside of the solar panel frame and the top of the XR1000 rail. And it's kind of hard to see, but right in between the rail and the module frames is the Weeb DMC we were looking at earlier. Notice that this panel frame is sitting on this side of the Weeb, and this panel frame is sitting on that side of the Weeb, which grounds this module and this module. Meaning, the next mid clamps up don't need the Weeb clip because this module is already grounded down here with this Weeb. We're going to wait till we get up here for our last row of mid clamps and use the Weebs again for this module and this module. This will vary a little bit depending on if you have columns of 3, columns of 4, or columns of 5. The next thing I want to discuss is the grounding lug. You're going to put one of these grounding lugs on the tip of each XR1000 rail. You'll notice a channel here that's designed for a number 6 bare copper wire that you can run through. You cinch it down with this bolt here, and this is going to allow you to complete your equipment ground for the system. Up above, you'll notice a bare copper wire spanning across each rail. The ground lug is secured to the top extrusion of each rail, and the channel on the lug holds the number 6 bare copper wire. You can put these along the top side of your array or along the bottom. It's totally up to you. The other thing while we have it up here is the end cap. Pretty simple. Keeps the end of the rail nice and clean and keeps the bugs out. I recommend using a rubber mallet. Just give it a light tap and those things are going to lock right on there. Now that we've taken a look at the various components of the ground mount system, let's get up close and see exactly where they're located on the ground mount. Alright, so let's take a look. We got the XR1000 rail right here, rail connector bracket, 3-inch U-bolt, horizontal 3-inch pipe, vertical 3-inch pipe, IronRidge top cap right here, two set screws in the back, two U-bolts right here securing the horizontal pipe. You're going to replicate this same thing on your northern piers in the back. As you can see, the piers in the back are going to be much taller. This is what sets your tilt angle. Your technician at Wholesale Solar will design the system based on your location and your power requirements. We can adjust the tilt angle from a flush mount all the way up to 45 degrees. You'll see we've just replicated the same thing we did in the front. Got the top caps, rail connector brackets, same thing on every pier going down.
Just to the right of the rail connector bracket right here, you'll see the 3-inch coupler I've used to connect two pieces of pipe. That allowed me to keep extending right on out to the edge of the array where the horizontal stopped.
The steel pipe that you're going to put in the ground is something you source locally. We're going to send you a detailed project report that shows you exactly how many lineal feet of pipe you're going to need for your installation. On the project report, you're going to notice an AGL length. That stands for above grade length, and that's what sets the tilt angle of your system. For instance, my southernmost piers are about 2 feet out of the ground. My northern piers here are a little over 6 feet out of the ground, and I've achieved right around a 25 degree tilt on this particular ground mount.
Something I want to point out real quick. If you've ordered a system that uses DC optimizers or microinverters, be sure to mount those to the top extrusion of the rail before placing the solar panels on.
Thanks for joining me. I hope you found the video informative. I hope you have a better understanding of how the IronRidge ground mount system works. If you have any questions at all, give us a call at Wholesale Solar. We're happy to answer any questions you have and make sure you have everything you need for a successful ground mount installation.